To your loving Father.
亲爱的在天上的父。
Father, you gave us truth.
亲爱的天父，是你给我们真理。
We need to understand truth.
我们要明白真理。
So we can truly give this truth to other people.
所以我们也能够把真理传开。
There's a full of lies and false information in this world today.
在今天的世界里充满了谎言和虚假的道理。
And let us understand the truth by your Holy Spirit today.
让我们因着你圣灵的充满，能够明白你的真理。
Be with us in this room at this time.
求主在这个时候与我们同在。
So we may truly understand.Your truth.
使我们真正明白你的真理。
Father, thank you so much for this opportunity.
父，特别感谢你给我们这样一个好的机会。
That you assigned to this wonderful two sisters.
你让我们有这样的一个巧合。
Professor Gun and Quark.
有跟姊妹，我们都聚在一起。
And use them.
然后。
As your most important instrument in this country.
还有最重要的这个国家里面的传播手段。
By awakening them. By awakening them to the
能够唤醒他们
wonderful truth you gave us.
让他们也能够明白你给我们这么奇妙的真理。
In Jesus' name.
祷告奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen. Our genes requires very strict environment.
其实我们基因需要的环境是非常严格的。
So genes are simply DNAs.
基因其实就是 DNA.
DNA is a simple chemical structure.
DNA 实际上就是化学结构。
See, no matter how much you love DNA on the table.
不管你怎么样，桌子这个物质的这个 DNA，
this DNA would never react to that love。
你怎么爱桌子，它的 DNA 都没有任何反应。
For DNA to respond to love，
DNA 如果要对爱做出反应，
DNA has to be in the cell。
必须是在细胞里边。
Yeah, this is amazing, really.
是不是很
奇妙 The cellular environment is very special environment.
细胞的环境实际上是特别特别特殊的环境。
The purpose of the cell is giving the proper environment for the DNA.
细胞的目的实际上就是给 DNA 一个合适的环境。
And so cell has to be in very healthy condition.
所以细胞需要很健康的环境。
Also, the DNA has to be in the nucleus.
而且 DNA 要在细胞核里边。
This is a double segregation.
它是双层的这种。
So DNA has to be in very special environment.
所以 DNA 需要很特别的环境。
And with the right nutrition.
而且要合适的营养。
Right a proportion of all different.Substances.
而且需要所有物质的合适的比例。
And with right temperature.
而且还有合适的温度。
DNA requires very strict environmental requirements.
对于 DNA 的环境来讲非常严格。
Then chi comes.
这时候就有了气。
And then DNA begins to respond.
这时候 DNA 才会做出应有的反应。
So, in the purpose of a health message is
对于我们健康信息的目的来说
that we are trying to let the people know the importance of the qi.
我们就是想让普通人明白气的重要性
which is the Holy Spirit.
就是圣灵
which is God's love.
其实就是上帝的爱
with that qi. God created.
这就是上帝用气创造了世界。
With that qi, God formed the atom.
就是气，上帝创造了原子。
So qi is everything.
气是一切。
So that is the first angel's message.
其实这是第一位天使的警告。
First angel's message says,
第一位天使
是在空中，
他说当敬畏上帝。
Who created?
那创造天地海。
And the why Sabbath is important.
安息日是很重要的。
Because God put the qi in the Sabbath.
因为上帝把气给了安息日。
That we call blessing.
我们把它称作赐福与安息日。
You know what Ellen White says?
在怀爱伦的书里面。
Blessing is healing power.
他说福气实际上就是医治之能。
See, so.It is very important for us to know what to teach the people.
我们真的要明白，要跟弟兄姐妹讲什么。
We're always trying so hard to teach the Saturday is Sabbath day.
我们总是要跟大家讲，就是第七天才是安息日。
Instead of Sunday.
然后讲不是第一日，不是星期天。
That's not important.
这个不重要。
Importance is in that Saturday.
重要的是在星期六安息日。
There is a power.
有上帝的能力。
The qi is in the Saturday.
就是因为安息日是有气的。
Because of the importance of the qi.
因为气的重要。
Sabbath exists.
才会有安息日的意义。
See, because of it's a qi is Jesus Himself.
因为气就是耶稣自己
yes, and the love
是爱
unconditional love
毫无条件的爱
the love has the power
因为爱就有能力
so Jesus is in that day called Sabbath day
当耶稣在这一天的时候耶稣把这一天称作安息日
and that's why that day is holy
所以这一天成为圣洁
that's why God saysI made Sabbath holy.
所以上帝说我定安息日为圣日。
Holiness is a nature of God.
圣洁不就是上帝的本性吗？
Without God, nothing is holy.
人非圣洁就不是上帝的本性。
And so Sabbath is a day in which the qi is.
安息日里面就是因为有气。
Healing power.
医治的权柄
that is power of creation
创造的权柄
and that is Jesus himself
这不就是耶稣自己吗
that's why that day is very holy
所以这一天成为圣洁
there's nothing more important than that day in this holy universe
在全宇宙当中没有什么比这一天更重要的
so when God says I gave youMy Sabbath day.
所以上帝说我把安息日赐给你们。
You can see that in Ezekiel chapter 20, verse 12.
在以西结二十章第十二节。我们看一下以西结书二十章。以西结书二十章十二节这样说又将我的安息日赐给他们好在我与他们中间为证据使他们知道我耶和华是叫他们成为圣的
Yes, he says I gave them my Sabbath
他说又将我的安息日赐给他们
God used the word gave
上帝把这个赐写在这里边。
Gave what?
赐我们什么呢
？My Sabbath.
赐给我们他的安息日。
So my Sabbath does not simply mean my all those Saturdays, you know.
在这里，我的安息日不是指的我的所有的礼拜六。
Well, Saturdays, you know, it is going to be there anyway, whether God give us or not.
上帝给不给我们礼拜六？礼拜六都是有的。
But when God says, I gave my Sabbath,
但上帝却说我赐给你我的安息日
that means I gave myself. I gave my chi.
就是我要赐给你们安息日，我要赐给你们气。In
every Sabbath Saturday.
在每一个星期日，每一个安息日，这就是上帝要给我们的。And
to be a sign between them and me.
而且成为他们和我之间永远的证据。That's
what Jesus says. I am the Lord of Sabbath day.
所以耶稣说，我就是安息日的主，人子是安息日的主。That's
what Jesus says. Sabbath is for men.
所以他说，安息日是为人设立的。
To heal.
为了能够痊愈,
to recreate.
为了能够再造,
that means to heal.
就是要医治之能啊。
So, remember this.
所以别忘了这一点。
The main goal of our health message is
我们健康信息的最后的目的,
for the people to know
就是让人知道,
the Creator.
创造主啊。
The healing is recreation.
医治其实就是再造。
So, you know, unfortunately, many people introduce people to the, oh, this is very healthy food, this is healthy food, this is healthy food.
今天许多弟兄姐妹把福音传给别人之后都说吃这个健康，吃那个好。
Where is the Creator?
那上帝呢？
So, construct, design your lecture.
所以当你去讲的时候,
to be able to reveal the Creator.
就是要让别人知道上帝创造主。
That's the lecture which is going along with the three angels' message.
所以三天使的警告就是带来让我们认识创造主。
Because I was always curious.
我有时候总是很好奇。
See, why God says, worship the Creator in the first angel's message.
所以为什么在第一位天使的警告当中说当敬畏上帝呢？为什么？
Aren't all Christians worship God who is Creator?
那所有人敬拜的上帝不都是创造主吗？
Or even Catholics worship Creator.
那天主教徒他们也在敬拜创造主。
Catholics don't believe in evolutionism.
那有时候相信这个进化论的人他们也有。
All Christians believe in Creator.
所有基督徒的他们都拜。
Why God is asking to all the world, and including Christians, to worship the Creator?
那上帝为什么给全世界，特别是基督徒有一个信息，说要敬拜创造主？
The main reason is the Christians don't worship the Creator.
就是因为基督徒敬拜的不是创造主。
But that is revealed so clearly.
实际上是很清晰的。
When people are sick.
When people.
People are sick.
当人们生病的时候。
When people are sick, they don't think God can heal them.
对弟兄姐妹生病的时候，没觉得上帝能治好他呀。
Yeah. They look for something else.
他们就去找别的办法。So
people do not worship.
所以是弟兄姐妹，他们没有敬拜上帝。
99% of Christians don't worship the Creator.
99%的基督徒不拜创造主。
Even though you're Seventh-day Adventist, you don't worship the Creator.
我们福音信徒也不敬拜创造主。
And so God gave us a health message.
所以上帝把健康的信息给了我们。
And for us to experience.
让我们能够经历。
Creator's power
经历创造主的能力,
to make us whole,
让我们痊愈,
to be healed,
能够健康,
and to experience the holiness of God.
让我们能够理解上帝的完全,
that's every week,
所以每周,
every Sabbath day,
每一个安息日,
and the Creator has power of creation.
创造主有创造的能全能。
And you know, I am always very amazed about Ellen White.
有时候我读到怀世母的书，觉得非常的吃惊。
Many people doubt Ellen White.
许多人怀疑，不相信怀世母。
But when I read Ellen White's writing,
当我读到怀世母的书，
and I find this is so fascinating.
觉得太奇妙了。
Yeah. And I don't know in China, but in America, everybody says, oh, Sabbath is memorial of creation.
我不知道在中国的弟兄姐妹是怎么样，美国的弟兄姐妹一到安息日就会说啊，安息日是创造的纪念。
How about in China?
The same.
Same. Yeah. But you know what Ellen White wrote?
但是你知道怀圣母是怎么写安息日吗？
Ellen White did not write that way.
怀圣母没有这样写。
Ellen White says, the Sabbath is memorial of the power of creation.
他说的是安息日是纪念上帝创造的全能。
Yes, the chi.
他说是气。
So God put the chi every Sabbath day to memorialize the creation.
上帝就是让气成为我们安息日的证据，让我们能够去纪念。
And but we take Sabbath as a memorial day to commemorate creation.
我们老以为安息日就是去纪念上帝的创造。
We lose power.
然后权柄就没有了。
And so we lose entire point.
所以我们忘记了最重要的一点。
And Sabbath become a special kind of doctrine.
所以安息日成了一个特别的教训。教义。
And which lost its power.
教义就没有了能力。
So, you know, there are many people today say, do you have to keep the Sabbath to be saved?
那么大家都在问，是不是不遵守安息日就不能够得救？
If you say yes,
如果你答案是对，
you become legalist.
然后你就成了这个律法。
But my answer is yes.
但我也说是对。
Why?
为什么？
Because without that power,
因为如果没有安息日的权柄，
How can you be saved?
你怎么能够得救啊？
So people will not keep Sabbath day.
那些不遵守安息日的人，
When they don't know,
他们不知道的时候，
When they don't know what Sabbath is,
他们不知道什么是安息日，
so
安息日是什么？
That's what we need to teach people Sabbath day.
所以我们要告诉别人什么是安息日。
To teach the Sabbath day,
要讲安息日，
we have to let them know what the qi is.
要给大家讲什么是qi。
If you don't know the qi, there is no Sabbath day.
其实安息日如果离了qi就不是安息日了。
If you don't really receive the qi which is in the Sabbath day,
如果不能够接受安息日里面的qi,
you don't get anything.
你什么也得不着。
You simply got the Saturday.
你只得到了礼拜六。
And unfortunately, many Adventists are that way.
但是很遗憾，福音信徒大多如此。
So we cannot really present to other Christians and other people what the qi is.
是因为我们别人看不到我们所讲的这个qi。
So qi can be revealed. Qi can be revealed most powerfully in the healing process.
所以在医治的过程当中，气就完全的显明了。
That's why God gave us His messages.
所以上帝要把健康的信息给我们。
To reveal the qi to the people.
就是要让人家明白气。
The qi is the power of creation.
气就是创造的权柄。
Which the qi created genes.
气创造了基因。
And qi can control the genes.
气也控制着基因。
And qi can reconstruct the genes.
也可以构造基因。
And recreate.
还可以再造基因。
And it eventually
heal. 最后能够使我们痊愈。
See, as you already listened to my lecture,
大家已经听了讲座。
The healing is the recovery of the gene.
人生病要好是基因的改变。
Which is being done by the qi.
是气的作用。
See, so if you make a sick people experience qi,
如果你让那些病人经历到气,
and this person is healed,
这个人就能够痊愈了。
Then they said, wow, it's not medication.
他说这不是靠药物的结果。
It's not the surgery.
也不是大夫做的手术。
It's the 气 healed me.
是气让我好了。
That's our job.
这就是我们要干的活。
Yes, that's why it is important for us to be a doctor or a pharmacist or scientist.
所以我们要做医生，不要做开药铺的。
Because as a professor in the medical school,
在医学院的教授里面,
you can explain to the people.
他们可以告诉普通的人,
we cannot heal.
我们好不了。
The chi coming from the creator.
We can be healed.
That's a we human being.
Okay, now. 我们不能使病好起来，是气使我们好起来。
We cannot change your genes.
因为我们改变不了你的基因。
How wonderful.
啊，这样多美好。
Things to teach.
我们可以这样告诉别人。
And so the chi is on the focus.
所以就是这个气是我们所有的焦点。
So first, what first angel's message really means is,
所以第一位天使的警告说的就是这一期。
God is asking us, know the qi.
他就说你要认识这个气。
Experience qi.
你要经历气。
See, that's what it really means.
实际上就是说这个。
Then what is qi then?
那么到底什么是气?
I already explained in my lectures.
在讲座里跟大家这样说,
eventually the qi is love of God.
气就是上帝的爱,
which is character of God.
这也就是上帝的品格,
the true character of God.
是上帝最真实的品格, 就是爱。
See, that true love of God has the power.
上帝的真爱是有大的权柄。
And here I said something very important. Love is power.
我已经跟他说，爱就是权柄。
And we also proved this love is power on our lecture.
我们已经在讲座里证实到这一点，爱就是权柄。
When you receive love,
当你得到爱了,
your genes activate.
然后基因就开始作用。
So power and the love is not two different things.
所以爱和权柄不是两回事儿。
Because love is the power.
爱就是权柄。
It's the same thing.
是一样的一回事儿。
And today it became two different things.
但今天人们把它分开了。
And love is love. And love has no power to heal.
爱就是爱，爱没有什么本事了。
And this power heals.
你看，是这种权柄让你好。
The power and the love is now separated.
所以现在呢，爱和权柄分开了。
Ellen White said.
所以怀世母这样说。
In the Desire of Ages.
在一代愿望。
In English, and page 435.
在一代愿望书的。
I think it's 435. Yeah, 435. Yeah. And she said this.
她这样说,
Lucifer.
她说,
Lucifer. What Lucifer wanted was not the character of God.
她说,
and Lucifer wanted only power.
她要的是权柄。
Isn't that interesting?
对，很有意思。
Yeah. And this is, I think, what Ellen White said right here is something. She must be a prophet, you know?
她一定是神明白的。
This is deep thinking.
她想非常深刻。
In fact, what she says is,
她说的是什么呢?
Character, the love and the power is one.
他说上帝的品格，爱和权柄是一样。
And Lucifer did not want the character of God.
路西普不要上帝的品格。
Lucifer only wanted the power.
他只想要那个权柄。
Why?
为什么呢?
Why?
为什么呢?
I think This is the key point you must understand. Why Lucifer refused to have God's character?
Why did Lucifer not have God's character?
Do you have any idea? Lucifer did not like God's character.
Lucifer didn't like God's character.
Think about it.
想一想, 为什么?
Because Lucifer thought God's love is powerless.
因为Lucifer觉得上帝的爱太脆弱了，太软弱了。
It's weak.
太软弱了。
Because according to God's character,
因为根据上帝的品格,
God forgive.
上帝饶恕人,
forgive.
又饶恕人。
Unconditionally forgive.
从没有条件的饶恕人。
Even the sinner does not repent.
那不悔改的罪人, 上帝还愿意饶恕。
God forgive.
上帝要饶恕。
And God even loves his enemy.
上帝还要爱仇敌。
Lucifer could not understand that love.
哎呀, 路西弗他无法明白。
Lucifer is in high position in the heavenly government, as you know.
在天庭里面, 路西弗的位置很高。
Lucifer worried about this heavenly government.
他为这个天庭操了很多心。
If God keep on forgiving, and even loving his enemy,
上帝总是饶恕怜悯, 还要爱他的仇敌。
What is going to happen?
那会怎么样呢?
In the future.
那以后会怎么样?
In case someone decided to rebel against.
如果有人反抗上帝的时候,
well, God will forgive again.
上帝就会要饶恕这家伙。
Then there's no law and order.
好像就没有了法律规章。
So Lucifer thought.
所以路西弗他想的不一样。
You know, this love is against the justice.
爱是不公义的呀。
You know, I hear the same thing from many ministers today.
今天很多传道人都说这样的话。
Right?
对不对?
So that's why Lucifer separated God's mercy and God's justice.
所以路西弗把上帝的怜悯和他的公义分开了。
Lucifer says, "Love is love, justice is justice."
所以路西弗让人这样去想，爱就是爱，公义是另外一回事。
So Lucifer said, "Okay, you can love God."
所以他说，你可以爱上帝。
But there has to be justice.
但是公义怎么办？
This is almost every Christian is saying.
现在的基督徒都是这样说啊。
This is what exactly Lucifer insists.
这是路西弗的看法。
Okay, you can see, you can read this in a Desire of Ages.
历代愿望里面有这样。
I think it's about page 765 or something. Ellen White wrote this.
所以怀仁写到了这一点。
And So Lucifer said to God, this is problem. If your love, which is unconditional love, will cause great problem, which we all agree.
我们都同意，对吧？我们都同意。
You know, God's love gives freedom of choice.
上帝的爱给你完全的自由选择权。
Right?
对吗?
Yeah. He gives us freedom of choice.
他让我们自由的选择。
And God wants us to have a loving relationship with Him.
上帝让我们与人彼此相爱。
As Ellen White says, God never forces anyone.
上帝从来不是说他强迫人彼此相爱。
If we choose our own way,
如果我们用自己的方式选择，
I'm a loss, yeah.
可以这样做。
Okay, now you know Lucifer insisted there should be difference between God and between God's love, mercy, and justice.
路西弗他坚持认为，在上帝的爱和公义之间是完全不同的。
Could you tell me what is the then justice of God?
那你说什么是上帝的公义呢？
What is justice?
所以什么是上帝的公义啊？
To me,
对我来说，
justice of God means this.
上帝的公义就是
God gave us freedom choice.
就是上帝给我们自由的选择权。
If God says,No more freedom of choice.
如果上帝说没有选择了，
that God is not God of justice.
那上帝就不公义了。
See?
对。
God promises that freedom of choice.
因为上帝已经应许给我们选择权。
Or God says,
上帝说，
You didn't listen to me.
你？
You disobeyed me.
你没听。你
I'm going to punish you.
你竟然违背我，所以要惩罚你。
That is not the justice.
这就不公义了。
If he gave us justice, gave us freedom of choice.
如果他给我们自由的选择权，
then he should not punish us.
他就不会惩罚我们了。
Even though we disobey.
即使我们违背他，悖逆。
Right. Because he gave us just a freedom of choice.
因为自由是他给我们的。
So.To me, the justice of God is giving us the freedom and keeping that promise.
所以对我来说，上帝的公义就是给我自由选择权，而且呢，保持这种应许。
Today, many of us think justice is punishing the people who disobeyed.
所以我们今天弟兄姐妹都觉得什么是公义啊？就是惩罚那些不听话的。
So this is.The misunderstanding of justice of God
这是对上帝公义的误解
is causing greatest misunderstanding in the character of God.
而且这是对上帝品格最大的误解
Right? When we Christians do not understand the character of God properly,
如果我们基督徒还不能够正确地认识上帝的品格
If we do not understandLove of God fully.
我们也不能够完全明白上帝的爱。
That we will not experience.
我们也不会去经历医治的权柄。
Because healing comes from love of God.
因为只有上帝的爱才给我们医治。
At this point, do you have any questions?
大家听明白了吗？
This is a very important point.
非常重要的一点。
See, this changes everything.
这会使一切发生改变。
You already noticed.
已经注意到这。
This will change everything.
这个社会使一切发生改变。
This will change your relationship with God.
这就会改变你跟上帝的关系。
Suddenly, love of God will become so beautiful.
在一瞬间，你会觉得上帝的爱是多么美好。
Or you may have problem.
要么你就会遇到问题。
Why?
怎么回事？
Because we learned the justice of God for a long time.
因为太久了，我们只了解到公义。
So justice of God is.That the Apostle Paul says in the 1 Corinthians chapter 13.
在这个哥林多前书 chapter
13.
在哥林多前书第十三章，保罗说
，Love does not get angry.
这爱是不轻易发怒。
Right. Why he should get angry?
那他为什么要发脾气呢
？When he gave us freedom of choice.
让他给我们自由的选择权。
See, Paul was an angry person before he knew God's character, right?
保罗在认识上帝品格之前是一个很 暴怒的人.
Yes, he was angry.
他生气,
he is the one who killed Stephen.
他杀的斯蒂凡.
Yeah, Stephen. Because Paul knew God. Apostle Paul's God was angry God.
保罗在那时候他认识的上帝是一个愤怒的上帝
who will kill
要杀
disobey
杀那些不顺从的人
and he killed Stephen
他杀了斯蒂凡
and Stephen was bleeding
那时候斯蒂凡都流血了
and Stephen was falling down
然后斯蒂凡倒了下去
and Stephen looked at the Paul
然后斯蒂凡他看着保罗
and the Paul was grinding his teeth
保罗还在他旁边愤怒
you must be killed
你还赶快死
you should die
你先最该万死
with anger and hatred
所以他还有愤怒 还有憎恨
looking at the
然后这时候斯蒂凡看着保罗 他说上帝啊 他说你饶恕他们吧
I want to see him in heaven
他说我就是想在天国里见到他
Unconditional
这是毫无条件的一种爱
That's the justice
这就是上帝的公义
But Paul thinks his action is justice
但那时候保罗觉得自己是对的呀 是公义的
And Paul thought what he did was judgment. But Stephen says, God, please act your justice on me.
所以这就是斯蒂堡有上帝，就实行你的公义吧。
Judge him and save him.
你要审判他，要救他。
And God answered the Stephen's prayer.
你觉得上帝听了斯蒂凡的祷告吗？ 对，他听了。
You know, in that evening,
在那天晚上,
Paul could not sleep.
保罗就睡着了。The
Stephen's face was.
他看到的是斯蒂凡的脸。It
was not Stephen's face.
他看的不是斯蒂凡的脸
Whose face was it?
你猜他看到他谁的脸
Jesus' face
对,他看到主的脸
And Paul began to have a struggle inside
这时候保罗就开始挣扎
Is this God true God or my God true God?
到底是他的上帝是真的还是我的上帝是真的呀
This God even loves me
这个上帝爱我
His enemy I am
我是他的敌人
And my God killed him
我的上帝杀他
His God loves me
他的上帝爱我
The character struggle
其实是品格在争斗
This is differences in the meaning the definition of justice
实际上就是对公义不同的理解在争斗
And the judgment.
审判的理解.
So everything becomes different.
所以一切都变得不一样.
So in the beginning,
开始的时候,
everything was one.
所有的事情都合为一.
Love and the power.
爱和权柄是一个.
And Satan separated.
但是撒旦把它分开了.
So love cannot heal.
爱治不了你的病
The power heals
是权柄治你的病
This is the whole world think that way
现在全世界都是这样想的
God does not heal
上帝治不了你
It is doctor heals
It is
The physicians heals
是医生而治你
Yeah So dualistic world
多么现实的世界
So God has no power
上帝没有什么办法
See So Satan separated power away from God.
所以撒旦拿走了上帝的权柄.
This is the beginning of dualism.
这就是二元论.
In the beginning, in the Old Testament,
在旧约时代,
there was no doctor.
根本就没有医生了.
Who is doctor?
谁是医生?
the priest,
祭司,
who has the word of God,
他们有上帝的话,
who knows the love of God.
那些人知道上帝的爱,
and all the sick people go to the priest.
所以有病的人都会找大祭司。
Priest give them instruction.
所以祭司会告诉他们怎么办。
New start.
告诉他们新起点的生活方式。
It was priest's job.
是祭司的工作。
So whenever I have the SDA ministers come to me,
所以有很多福灵信徒的牧师来。
I tell them,
我就跟这些牧师讲,
you are the physicians.
你们都是医生啊。
You think you are not the physician, I am the physician.
你们觉得你们不是医生, 医生是我。
You are deceived by Satan.
你们是被撒旦骗了。
See, I realized,
我明白了,
doctor can never be a doctor.
医生不是真正的医生。
Until a doctor knows God.
可是呢, 如果这医生认识上帝,
the true healer,
他就有了真实的医治的权柄。
Jesus Christ.
那就是耶稣基督。
And so this is the message in the health messages.
这就是今天健康信息的真理。
So Lucifer went to God and tried to persuade God.
所以路西弗来到上帝面前，试图说服上帝说
to change his policy.
你还是改变你的统治方法吧。
So Lucifer insisted there must be justice.
所以路西弗说你要公义啊。
That's right. Your love, there is no justice in your love.
在你的爱里没有公义。
See, so, you know, loving the people is okay.
你爱他随便。
But people go over the certain limit.
但是呢, 总是有限度的呀。
You must punish them.
这时候你要惩罚他。
So, they cannot go and sin anymore.
这时候他们就不会再犯罪了。
And God says, So at that time, nobody understand that, of course.
当然没有人在这之前明白。
Because there was no sin.
因为没有罪。
See? And so God says,
所以上帝说,
even though somebody sins,
即使有人犯罪,
somebody stand against me and rebel against me,
当有人成为悖逆的人，不听上帝的话，
I love them.
我就爱他们。
Then he will be changed.
然后他会改变。
And that love is everything.
所以爱能够唤起爱。
Lucifer says,
然后路西弗说,
what if someone don't change?
那如果你爱他，他还不改呢？
And repeat that rebellion.
不改呢，每天还在重复犯罪。
What are you going to do?
这时候你怎么办呢？
God says, I love him again.
上帝说，我还继续爱他。
Lucifer said, three times.
三次。
See, Lucifer asked the same question Peter asked Jesus.
所以彼得问的问题也正是路西弗所问过的。
You forgive forever?
你永远的饶恕吗？
490 times?
49次可不可以？
Jesus said yes.
然后耶稣说是。
And Lucifer could not understand.
这时候路西弗却不明白。
This will be a big problem.
会很麻烦的，你这样做。
This will destroy the integrity of the heavenly government.
这时候你就会扰乱天庭了。
So Ellen White says,
所以怀师母这样说,
Lucifer decided to rebel against God.
所以路西弗自己决定要反对上帝。
To reform the heavenly government.
他要重新组建天庭。
Isn't that interesting? So Lucifer wanted to help God.
所以路西弗实际上是想帮忙。
And Lucifer believed he is thinking is right.
而且路西弗知道自己想的是对的。
So Lucifer decided to rebel.
所以他决定反叛。
And at that point, he thought his idea is superior than God's idea.
那时候他觉得自己比上帝要聪明，要有远见。
He went beyond the line.
他就跨过了自己的界限。
And he felt that if God keep on forgiving him, even his rebelling against God, whose victory?
是谁的胜利呢?
Lucifer will win.
然后路西弗他会赢吗?
Because God forgive and forgive and forgive.
因为上帝不断地饶恕他，饶恕他，再饶恕。
But on the other hand,
但是我们从另一面看,
if God finally decided to punish Lucifer,
但是如果上帝最终决定该惩罚你了,
then it's again Lucifer's victory.
然后路西弗还赢了。
All the angels will say,
所有的天使都会说,
Wow, Lucifer was right!
你看路西弗对吧?他本来就是对的。
So Lucifer thought he can never lose.
所以路西弗以为自己输不了这场战争。
That's why he already knew he will be the victorious one.
所以其实他心里早已经有数,他肯定能赢。
So he decided he will become the ruler of the universe.
所以他觉得他肯定是这宇宙的主宰，没问题，指定是他。
See, this is origin of the sin.
这就是罪恶的起源。
Origin of sin is against the God's character.
罪恶的起源实际上就是违背上帝的品格。
Okay. And we keep on saying, origin of the sin is disobeyed obedience.
所以我们那时候都是说什么是罪恶的起源，不顺从。
So, Lucifer has to tell everyone he is the ruler.
所以这时候路西弗就开始告诉全天地的人，他是统治者。
But he couldn't do that.
但是他做不到。
Why?
为什么呢?
God is the creator.
因为上帝是创造主。
Everybody knows he is the creator.
因为每个人都了解上帝的创造。
Yeah, and Lucifer himself is a creature.
因为路西弗本人也是被上帝造的。
How can a creature be superior than creator?
那怎么受造的会超过创造主呢?
That's why Lucifer decided to make a creation meaningless.
所以这时候路西弗就决定创造让它毫无意义。
So Lucifer said,
所以路西弗说,
God only created body.
上帝只是创造了身体。
But the body had no mind.
但是身体是没有思维的。
The mind came from soul.
那么这个头脑是从灵魂来的。
Where the soul came from?
那什么是灵魂呢?
Soul was there in eternity.
灵魂是不死的。
So God did not create a soul.
是上帝没有创造灵魂。
God only created body.
上帝只创造了身体。
So he separated mind and body.
所以他又把身体和头脑分开。
According to the gene,
我们从基因学理论看,
gene itself is God's mind.
其实基因就是上帝的思维嘛。
And God's love controls genes.
而上帝的爱呢，控制着人的基因。
So our mind is God's mind.
我们的头脑上就上帝的头脑。
Normally,
正常情况的时候,
but right now,
但是现在呢,
we chose Satan to control our genes.
我们却选择撒旦来控制我们的基因。
So our mind is Satan's mind.
所以现在人的头脑就是撒旦的头脑。
And so Lucifer says,
所以路西弗说,
souls are eternal beings.
知道吗? 灵魂不死, 永远存在。
So, therefore creation becomes meaningless.
所以创造就没意义了。
Because God just created body.
因为上帝不过创造了身体嘛。
The important thing is the soul.
最重要的是你的灵魂。
Which is not created.
灵魂不是创造出来的。
So creation became meaningless.
所以因此创造成了没有意义的事情。
It is just like today, if you believe in soul immortality,
就像今天人们相信灵魂不死的说法,
creation, which is resurrection, become meaningless.
那么复活创造都已经毫无意义。
Right? And Lucifer said, so finally Lucifer established soul immortality.
所以实际上最终是撒旦建立了灵魂不死的学说。
Body is a body.
身体让它去吧。
Mind comes from soul.
是你的头脑是灵魂给的。
Body is separate entity.
所以它把它分开了。
So there is a doctor who take care of body.
所以就让医生去管你的身体吧。
And the mind is for the priest.
所以祭司来管你的头脑。
There's no connection.
没有什么联系。
Entire world concept based on this dualism.
所以这个世界所有的最基础的理论就是二元论。
Medicine.
药物学。
Everything.
一切都是一
样。Is dualistic science.
都是二元论的科学。
Today we find the genes.
今天我们发现了基因。
Wow, this is dangerous to Satan.
撒旦非常害怕。
I don't think Satan really wanted to have the secret of the gene to be revealed.
撒旦根本不想让人了解基因的秘密。
Because genes are the letters.
因为基因是文字。
Which should be created.
因为文字是要创造的。
And then Satan will find out, you know, then people will find out.
撒旦担心人们发现了之后怎么办？
God created all the programs.
那是上帝创造这些程序啊。
And God controlled with His love.
是上帝把爱给了基因。
So that's why God could not give health message to any other church who believe in soul immortality.
所以相信灵魂不死学说的教会是无法接受上帝的健康信息的。上帝没办法给他们。
God could only give health message to the people who believe in.Soul immortality theory is a false.
所以只有是我们教会不相信灵魂不死学说的人，才得到了上帝的健康信息。
But unfortunately,
但是很遗憾
we Adventists are using health message on dualistic basis.
我们也用健康信息，然后来服务于二元论。
We keep on saying.This is make you healthy.
我们不停地告诉别人啊，吃这个你就健康了。
We live along the Creator.
我们就让上帝做自己的事儿去吧。
And so, his message and the entire concept of Bible is together.
实际上，健康信息和整本圣经是连在一起的。
So that's why it is very important.For us to understand God's character.
所以我们一定要明白上帝的品格。
Okay, so now according to God's character,
我们看一看上帝的品德。
He gave us freedom of choice.
他把自由选择权给了我们。
Then what is punishment?
那惩罚是什么意思呢？
What is punishment?
什么是惩罚？
Bible says God punished.
上帝也说上帝要惩罚。
What does it mean?
是什么意思呢？
Punishment means... Punishment is...consequence of our wrong choice.
什么是追讨人的罪呢？实际上是人选择错误的结果。
The punishment is something which is not God gave us.
惩罚不是上帝给的。
Because we disobeyed.
不是因为我们违背他，他就给了我们惩罚。
Then there is a question.
那么问题出来了。
Then why in the Old Testament?
但为什么在旧约时候
，God says I punished you because you disobeyed me。
上帝会说：“我追讨你的罪，因为你的悖逆。”
Do you have any idea? Answer.
那大家知道为什么吗？
对，I think.This is a very important question, and you should be able to answer that question.
这个问题大家一定要会回答。
Cancer cell.
So cancer is not the God's punishment.
Cancer cell.
No.
Cancer cell is I suppose they need a T cell. T cell, 它是主动那个 B7 拼出来，我是该死的。
Okay. Now, God's love will give us freedom of choice.
上帝的爱把自由给了我们。
And God's love is being responsible for everything.
上帝的爱是对一切事情负责的。
That's revealed on the cross.
在十字架上我们可以看到。
On the cross, Jesus takes all responsibility.
在十字架上，耶稣承担了一切的罪。
For all people.
所有人。
You know, I don't know about China, but in Korea, the parents does not give freedom of choice.
在韩国，孩子没有自由。
I don't know about her parents. She's a very special person who enjoys freedom of choice.
说这个赵姊妹嘛，很有自由选择权，好像她很特别，是不是因为父母给了她自由选择权呢？
But normally, Korean parents, they control the children.
通常在韩国，父母控制着孩子。
I want you to be a doctor.
以后要当大夫。
That child has to become a doctor.
这个必须当大夫。
And then if the child says, I don't want to go to medical school, the parent says, I'm not going to provide you anything.
你说那就断绝跟你的经济供应。
The child asks, why do you want me to be a doctor?
为啥要让我当医生呢?
And because that's best for you.
因为对你最好，你还不明白。
I don't think that's for you.
I don't take that.
And Charles says, I don't think it is best for you.
啊，我不觉得。
I want to be a singer.
我想唱歌，出名当歌星。
My parents said, singer is bad.
唱歌星多坏呀。
The doctor is better.
医生好点。
And Charles says, I want to do what I like to do.
孩子说，我想干自己决定的事儿。
And mother says, I know better.
母亲就说，我知道比你知道的多。
You have to listen to me.
你就听我的吧。
And the child says, why do you force me?
那你为什么要强迫我呢?
Mother says, because I love you.
我强迫你是因为我爱你，懂不懂?
What a love.
这就是爱。
And that, the concept of love is so different.
所以爱的概念成了这样的概念。
So, when we say God is love,
当我们说上帝就是爱的时候,
you don't know what you're talking about.
大家其实根本不知道说的是什么。
See, when Korean Christian says God is love,
当其他国家弟兄姐妹说上帝是爱的时候,
see, in reality,
事实上,
today, in Korea, yes,
今天,
when they say God is love,
当他们说上帝就是爱,
you know what they think about God?
你知道他们是怎么想的吗? 什么是上帝?
God will force them to do anything.
上帝强迫他们做一切的事情, 所以你看上帝是爱。
You have no freedom.
没有自由。
If you're a Christian, you're God's servant.
你是基督徒, 你就成了上帝的仆人。
If you go to America,
你到美国看一看。
Parents give children freedom to choose.
美国的父母给孩子自由选择权。
Parents only give them their opinion.
父母只是提参考的意见。
If the children refuse the parents' opinion,
如果孩子拒绝,
then that's it.
然后就这样。
Parents says okay.
父母就说行。
And but in America,
但是美国,
if children make a mistake,
孩子犯错误了,
then parents says, we are not responsible.
父母就说, 你错是你的, 我不负责任啊。
You made your mistake.
这是你自己做错的。
So you have to solve your problem.
自己问题自己解决.
But in Korea, it's the other way around.
在不同国家就相反了.
You make mistake.
你做错事.
Parents take responsibility.
父母承担这一切的责任.
It is changing though now.
但现在事情有点不一样了.
And but God's love is not like Korean love or American love.
上帝的爱不是这样.
God's love is giving the children freedom of choice.
上帝的爱是给他的孩子完全的自由选择权.
At the same time,
而同时,
He's the one who's taking entire responsibility.
他负全部的全责.
Even though we make wrong choice.
即使我们做错事情, 自己选择错.
That's God's love.
上帝就是这样爱我们的呀.
Which is unconditional.
这个爱就是没有条件的.
And you know, I was trying to copy that God's love in my own life.
在我自己的生活里, 我想复制上帝的爱.
Very difficult.
太难了. 太难了.
One day my daughter came to me.
有一天我闺女来.
She said to me.
她说,
Daddy.
她说父亲啊,
you said you give us freedom of choice.
你是不是说了要给我们自由?
I choose to drink alcohol.
我喝酒行不行?
I already promised.
我已经答应他了.
I said, I wish that does not happen to you.
我只是说希望你不要这样做.
She says, I am already drinking.
她说其实我已经喝上了.
Should I punish him?
我是不是要追讨他的罪啊?
If I punish her, that I'm not the justice, the father of justice.
如果我这时候惩罚他,
my daughter will resist. You told me that you give us freedom choice.
因为我闺女会说, 这选择权是你给我的, 我选择了之后你要罚我.
It is not justice.
这不是公义啊.
Because you're breaking a promise.
因为你说话不算数.
God will keep his promise.
我要说话算数.
That's why this whole world is like this.
所以你看世界像今天这样子。
So many people are rebelling against God.
许多人违背上帝。
So, my daughter was in the Adventist school.
我闺女是在福林学校。
Finally, the teachers discovered her drinking alcohol.
结果教会学校老师发现他喝酒.
And teachers called me.
这时候老师打电话给我.
Did you know this?
你是知道?
I said yes.
然后我说我知道.
So we decided to
let her go. Decided to
send them out.
然后就决定把他弄出去, 赶出去.
Limit.
除名.
Then I said to my daughter,
然后我对闺女说,
I didn't punish you.
我没有惩罚你, 孩子。
You punished yourself.
是你自己惩罚你自己。
I don't think school punished you.
是这个学校的惩罚。
And you knew the rules in the school.
因为学校有规定啊。
And now this is a consequence of breaking the rule.
这就是你违背法律的结果。
So people drink alcohol, smoke cigarette, having a cancer, and many people say, oh, God punished me.
大家觉得是我作孽, 上帝惩罚我。
It's not true. It is God, and they punish themselves.
是他们自己在惩罚自己。
Then why God says, I punished you?
那上帝为什么还说我要追讨人的罪呢?
It's because God wanted to be responsible.
这是上帝想负责任。
If God says,
如果上帝说,
it was your fault, you punished yourself.
说你看, 你自己的错吧, 你惩罚, 就你自己惩罚自己。
That's only the fact.
对, 这只是事实。
That's fact.
这是事实。
But God wants to be responsible.
但上帝却想负责任。
So even though I punished myself,
即使我惩罚我自己,
God says, I punished you.
上帝说是我惩罚你。
That's how he can be involved to heal me.
所以这时候上帝他会跟上帝有关系。
Of course, God feels he's being responsible.
上帝知道自己要负责任。
Because he gave us freedom of choice.
因为他给了我们自由的选择。
When my daughter was expelled from the school,
女儿从学校除名,
I felt responsibility.
我觉得我要承担责任。
See? Why? Because I gave her the freedom of choice.
因为我给了她选择权。
So, I end up telling her,
所以我跟她说,
See, Daddy gave you freedom of choice.
是爸爸给了你选择权。
So, that's why you drank alcohol.
然后你现在喝酒。
And school expelled you.
然后学校除名。
It's because of me.
是我不好。
I actually caused this problem.
是我引起的麻烦。
So, I still love you.
我还爱你。
That's God's character.
这就是上帝的品格。
And so, when people begin to understand this God's character,
当人可以明白上帝品格的时候,
they feel so touched.
他们就特别受感动。
And they begin to understand God better.
他们开始更加认识上帝。
And they begin to understand the Bible better.
也可以看明白圣经。
Because I will punish you does not really mean that he will punish us.
当上帝说我要追讨你的罪的时候, 不是上帝惩罚了你。
I will punish you means
我要追讨你的罪,
you will have a terrible consequences.
是因为你有了这种很糟糕的结果。
Because of your wrong choice.
你自己做错了选择的结果。
I will be responsible.
我要为他负责任。
So this is the really new revelation, true revelation on God's character.
这其实才是上帝的品格，真实的表现。
When people begin to understand this character of God,
当人们开始明白上帝的品格,
they are so touched.
他们特别受感动。
Really begin to experience the healing.
他们就开始经验这种痊愈的过程。
So in my New Start program,
所以在我的新起点的疗愈院,
I begin to teach them qi.
我开始跟大家讲气。
Then I begin to teach the character of God.
然后就告诉大家上帝的品格。
And people, wow, this is a wonderful God.
所以这时候人们会说，上帝是一个真好的上帝。
And So let's stop right here. And so you don't have to turn it off, turn this.